Hello, I am Mahesh Babu, member of the ID Advanced Cloud Engineering team at Microsoft. In this video, we will delve into the Azure Active Directory authentication methods inside dashboard. This dashboard serves as a centralized platform for monitoring how MFA multi-factor authentication is being utilized and which authentication methods are registered and being used within your organization. By leveraging this dashboard, organizations can enforce MFA registration for their end users and utilize the robust features provided by the conditional access policies. Let us dive right in. Built-in and custom roles with the required permissions have access to the authentication methods monitoring dashboard and its APIs as displayed on the screen. The Azure Active Directory authentication methods inside dashboard can be accessed via multiple avenues within the AD Microsoft Entra Admin Center. This include security, authentication methods, and monitoring section. Additionally, users may access the dashboard by navigating to the Usage and Insights tab under Monitoring and Health, followed by selecting the Authentication Methods Activity option. Registration tab offers valuable insights into user capabilities regarding multi-factor authentication, passwordless authentication, self-service password reset. By accessing this tab, administrators can effectively monitor the number of users with such capabilities. Users registration by authentication method show how many users are registered for each authentication method. Recent registration by authentication method show how many registrations succeeded and failed, sorted by authentication method. Sign-ins by authentication requirement shows the number of successful user interactive sign-ins that were required for single-factor versus multi-factor authentication in Azure AD. This does not include times when users were required to use multi-factor authentication from a third-party MFA provider. Sign-ins by authentication method shows the number of user interactive sign-ins, success and failures by authentication method used. It does not include sign-ins where the authentication requirement was satisfied by a claim in the token. Number of password resets and account unlock shows the number of passwords successfully changed and password resets by it can be self-service and by the admin over the time. Password resets by authentication method section show how many times users were able to successfully reset their password using different authentication methods and how many times they were not successful. User registration details. The registration detail report shows the following information for each user: user principal name, name of the user, MFA capable, passwordless capable, SSPR capable, registered or enabled, methods registered. It can be any one of these methods or a combination of them, or it can be all. The registration and reset event section displays information about the registration and reset activities that have taken place in the last 24 hours, last 7 days or last 30 days. It also has date, user principal name, username, activity type, it can be registration, reset, and the authentication method being used, and the status of the message. It can be success or failure. If it is failure, then the reason for the failure with an explanation. Bulk operation results page shows the status of all bulk requests that are waiting to be processed. If there are any errors, the page also includes the reason for each error. Thank you for watching this video.